1975 record you an album with a song.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Rez Ride. It is Thursday, so what that means is at 4 o'clock, it's time to jump in and it's time to cruise. This is KWTN 100.9 FM, and I'm your host today, MC BKC. Let me make sure our levels are here. I know I'm blowing it out there a little bit there. Anyway, let's get back into it. So KWTN 100.9 FM, I'm your host, MC BKC, and this is the Rez Ride coming to you live from Uptown Winnebago, KWTN 100.9 FM for all of you on terrestrial radio. And also, don't forget, you can go to YouTube, search for our channel, That Fire Though, T-H-O, and see us broadcasting live. Or you can click on the Winnebago Tribes Media Player tab and listen live from anywhere in the world. So I am joined live in the studio by... Hello? Oh, wrong one.
Four.
All right, go ahead.
Do Sharon.
All right, had the wrong number there.
Oh, okay. Hello, everybody. DJ Best of Me here.
All right, so how you guys feeling today?
Tired.
Tired? It's payday.
Payday.
It is payday, but bills are calling.
Bills, oh, yes. Bills, bills.
Yes.
But you can't not be fired up when you hear this song.
No, it's definitely made me want to move.
Yeah, it gets you going. So we're going to say this over and over again, guys. You're going to have a chance to win one of the brand new, hot off the press, KWTN, the Big Voice Radio t-shirts.
Ooh.
Yes, that we just got. So you got to listen in because we're going to have a little contest a little bit later on in the show. But we're going to get this party started with, of course, the opening... Oh my gosh, I'm just all over the place today. The opening song today, of course, is Black Legend with You See the Trouble with Me from way back in the day. We're always going to open the show with one of these hot cuts like that. But we're going to jump into a throwback favorite that I heard just the other day. And of course, I was able to find a radio-friendly version. So we're going to jump in to Tweet featuring Missy Elliott. I guess it was also featured on Euphoria from HBO.
Yeah.
So we're going to get into that. KWTN 100.9 FM. Let's go. This is the Rez Ride. Tell your friends because you get to win a t-shirt and maybe something else.
Swoop.
Let's rock.
Ooh.
Some kind of touch caressing my
And there you have it, ladies and gentlemen, the one and only, that is Tweet featuring Missy Elliott. There's also another version that has Fabolous on it, but there is not a radio-friendly version because Fabolous is potty mouth.
Oh man.
Yes, and can't get over it. So of course, this is the Rez Ride coming to you live on KWTN 100.9 FM. Now playing in the background is the one and only Mary J. Blige featuring Eve. And so let's get this party started. There's a lot of programming we're going to get into. We'll have, of course, our infamous Rez Ride Love Line coming up later. Of course, there's a new sensation that's a little bit of a double dip, guys, and you'll know it when we get there. And also, don't forget, listeners, you can win one of the brand new, seriously hot off the press. They were still warm in the box when they arrived today. The KWTN 100.9 FM, the Big Voice Radio t-shirts. If you go to our YouTube page, you can see them up on the camera right now. It's absolutely amazing. They are black in color with our logo, and they are amazing. So, you guys, I asked you this before. Are you ready to get into this today?
Let's go.
Okay. Do you like this song?
I love this song.
I haven't heard it in so long.
I know. I really like it. Especially when Eve comes in right here. Because you know what she says there. Okay, guys, so let's get it started. So, of course, we have a lot of other programming that happens here on KWTN 100.9 FM. Don't forget about my other show, Midnight Love, which comes to you every night at 10 p.m. with the new shows debuting on Fridays when they're ready. Last week, we debuted Midnight Love, Episode 43, Decades of Love, Volume 3. And that was absolutely amazing. I loved it. It was a deep, deep dive into the 1990s. And we barely pulled ourselves out of that. I should say I pulled myself out of it. And we went into and crossed the millennium boundary into the 2000s. So that was an amazing playlist.
I enjoyed from the 60s where you kicked it off all the way up till this one. So excited for it would be volume 4, right?
Yep. The next one that will come out of that series. It may not be the next show. Simply because I think we need to pay a little bit of attention to some of the other genres that we do. But at the same time, yes, Volume 4 will take us from the 2000s forward.
Mm-hmm.
So don't forget Midnight Love every night at 10 p.m. with the replays, and then the new shows debuting on Fridays at 10. And then, of course, All Requests Live, hosted by our one and only DJ Bessamy. All Requests Live on Thursdays from 11 to 1. The replay we just got done with as we came up to the beginning of Rez Ride. Mm-hmm. And the top 5 today, did we have a new winner?
Another new winner. Yep, knocked Rapper's Delight out of the... They held it down for 1 week. And now we have the Gap Band.
You dropped the bomb
on it. You dropped the bomb.
Nice.
Dang. Yep.
Choka Charlie Wilson. He was the lead singer for them. Yep, so now that's a good one. You dropped a bomb on me.
Suppose made him a choker.
Well, choker, don't quit hitting the microphone.
Oops.
Okay, of course, ladies and gentlemen, that was Mary J. Blige featuring Eve with Not Today. Now, this is a cut that you may not have heard too much of, but this is The Roots featuring Cody Chestnut, and it's called The Seed.
Okay.
Did you ever hear it before?
No.
Sharon Teed? Nope.
I like it.
It's a really good song, and maybe we should turn it up here. But don't forget, with All Requests Live every Thursday from 11 to 1 with the replay at 2, leads us up to Rez Ride. Then, of course, following Rez Ride tonight, Baby Bison Beats is going to have a new show.
Yes, they will.
So MC Ash and Lil Zane?
Yes, 7 to 8 Thursday evenings.
Yes, so follow our social media as well, because I know you did put out a post, and they are going to be doing movies?
Yes, songs from movies.
Oh, nice.
Yes. So I wonder what kind of movies they pick.
I know, I'm wondering what they watch.
I think that you all enjoy it.
Really?
Yes.
Okay, so we'll look for that Baby Bison Beats on Thursdays, and then, of course, The Big Hour, which comes to you every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, where one of the DJs here at KWTN takes you down the path of musical righteousness. And we went all over the place because yesterday, DJ Guaranteed, on the wheels of steel, as he likes to say, took us to Jamaica, man.
Oh, did he?
Yes, he did a reggae show, and it was good.
Yes.
Because he didn't just, you know, stick with the really super well-known stuff. He played some of it, don't get me wrong. But he also added in some of the other sub-genres as well, such as rock reggae. You ever know that existed?
Mm.
Yep, he threw some of that in and really went all over the place. And then, of course, DJ Besame did her artist spotlight the last time around, and that was Tom Petty.
Mm-hmm. Really?
Yep, yes. Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers got a whole hour's worth of music.
Mm-hmm. Man, I'm really missing out.
Yeah, you gotta tune in.
I work. I'm sorry. I got a lot on my plate.
You can have the radio on.
And it distracts me. Then I have to get up and dance or sing or...
Gotta bust a move.
I know, I really do.
All right. So anyway, but yeah, you can always turn the radio on KWTN 100.9 FM or click the media player and it can be playing in the background. But anyway, the Big Hour comes to you every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, so tune in for that. And we will always have something set up for you. And then, of course, Friday Night Hot Mix with the one and only DJ Blue. If you're in the mood to party on a Friday night.
I'm in the mood.
Yes, tune in. Let's go. And DJ Blue will take you down that path and just leave you there. No.
Then push you into the weeds.
Pick you up next Friday.
Oh my God.
I know, where's DJ Guaranteed? It's act up season. Yeah, let's go.
Let's go.
But yeah. On that same note, I want to throw out there, MC BKC and I will be here in the studio tomorrow. Yep. So if you missed out on our request portion for Thursdays, we'll have a live request show tomorrow for the Big Hour.
I don't have any meetings tomorrow. Let's go.
Well, come on up. And
pop up. Yes. I'll try to pop up.
Yep, so get some people and request the songs 402-922-3347 and you can get a radio friendly song.
I want to request the one right now.
Okay, what?
Luke Bryan just let some new songs out.
Oh, really?
Oh, and
okay,
I was.
They're released.
Yeah.
Okay, we have to look for them.
Okay. So, oh.
What?
My phone's dying.
Good.
So.
We have your charger. Good.
I know, because whoever keeps calling and texting you, she's busy.
I'm always busy.
Yeah, so don't forget about DJ Blue on Friday nights, and then of course Bago Talks on Tuesdays, where DJ Guaranteed hosts everything and anything Winnebago tribe, and it truly goes all over the map. We recently had prenatal care up here, we've had STD awareness, and then most recently we also have a 911 message that is getting put out. The emergency director for the Winnebago tribe, Julie Smithart, she has asked us to help forward that information. Oh, okay, guys.
I have a question
Hold
for
on.
You.
That was The Roots featuring Cody Chestnut with The Seed. Now this is Mary J. featuring Diddy and Lil Wayne, Someone to Love Me.
Love it.
This is an awesome song. Anyway, your question?
So is the correct term now, instead of STD, disease, STI. Is it STI?
I believe so.
Is it a disease or is it an infection now? Or does it...
Honestly, I don't think it matters because chlamydia
that.
Is chlamydia.
Yes.
It's like whatever. So whichever phrase works for you at the same time, they brought awareness to
the
big,
well, I was just saying that because they had some... things happening in town where if you go in and got checked or whatever, and you got a gift card and all that, but they were calling it STI, so I was like, what am I getting? And then they told me, I was like, oh, okay, wow.
Well, anyway, so yes, whatever you call it, STD, STI, that type of thing.
But, BD.
And it's not always about that. Of course, the point is Bago Talks goes everywhere and anywhere. So if there's information out there in the Winnebago community, by all means, get a hold of DJ Guaranteed, garen.coons@winnebagotribe.com, and he will do his best to make sure that you have a space on Bago Talks. Remember, it's Tuesday mornings.
Okay.
All right, guys. So we have all that kind of programming, and we're going to give this one a listen. Mary J. Blige featuring Diddy and Lil Wayne, Someone to Love Me. Turn it up, guys. KWTN 100.9 FM. Don't hang on him anymore. You know what I'm looking for.
Someone to love me. Virgin Mary. Go ahead, make my day dirty, Harry. Weezy, the world pop the cherry. Everybody pushing, but I don't fall back. And everybody looking, but blind to the fact. The clock on the wall says it's time for some action. Now you could take that to the bank and cash in. I'm feeling myself, if they feeling me. Can't spell them without me, it's them or me. Yesterday was a memory, looking in the mirror at my enemy. But today I'm
looking for someone to love me. I'm looking for someone to love me. Yeah, yeah, yeah. My rise, my fall. Enemies wanna see me crawl. My ups, my downs. Y'all know I've been around, but sometimes it bothers me when I hear people saying untruth. Am I sane? Am I crazy? Pick one, they're all the same. In this world we're living in, I'ma make mistakes, I'm only human. I was looking for someone to love me. I'm looking for someone to love me. Yeah, 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 yeah.
Everybody needs somebody to love them.
KWTN 100.9 FM. This is the Rez Ride coming to you live. And that was, of course, the one and only Mary J. Blige featuring Diddy and Lil Wayne with Someone to Love Me. Love that song. It's got such a funky beat and a funky vibe. So now we're transitioning into a group called Young Guns featuring Rel. A little bit of throwback. You recognize the music? I think I might wife her. You know, pot of blue rocker with suit. Is white Nike. My niggas like her. She been Luther Vandross. Girl, you put in that top like Ben Lifers. But they're sampling it there. Okay, guys, don't forget Rez Riders, KWTN 100.9 FM. In a little while, we are going to have our contest. We're going to be giving away a t-shirt with the brand new KWTN, the Big Voice Radio logo. And so it will be your chance to win this t-shirt, and we will make sure that we get it out to you. So 402-922-3347 will be the text line, so write it down, 402-922-3347, or you can go to YouTube and watch where we're broadcasting live from the studio under our channel, That Fire Though, T-H-O, and you can watch and see what's happening here live, but you will also be able to provide your answer to the question or to the whatever we put out there so you can win the prize. Okay, guys, so up next, there's something that I wanted to throw out there. And because, of course, we're going to be doing our top five topic of the day, and I know it's really going to stretch your guys' minds here because it's not something we usually talk about.
Okay.
So I'll definitely give you guys time, or who knows, maybe you'll rattle them off. Our top five topic of the day is going to be top five comedians, meaning the people that are out there doing the stand-up. Now, if they're in movies, great, but if you can, try to focus on those that actually stand on the stage and make people laugh. Can you think of five?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay, because we're also going to have honorable mention, because when I was putting my list together, I was like, oh my god, I can't forget them. Or I can't forget this one. Or I can't forget that one. So top five comedians is going to be our topic of the day. And then if you can, tell us a little about the act or why you like them in the way that you do. Okay?
Got it.
All right. So again, this is Young Guns featuring Rel with No Better Love. So let's get into the celebrity birthdays, guys. Ready?
Yes.
All right. A lot of people celebrating their birthdays this week. And so starting us off is the one and only MC Delight.
Yes.
Happy birthday to you. You got to sing it like that, too. Yeah, so she's out there celebrating her birthday. And how old is she?
42.
55?
The 40s she's are the new 20s.
Yeah, so something out there. So
she's
happy birthday.
Single and ready to mingle.
Oh, definitely. So happy birthday, MCD. I hope you're enjoying your day, MC Delight. So she could have came here and partied with us, brought us some cake, see how she is.
She wanted to go home and visit her grandma. She likes spending her birthday with her grandma.
Oh, true. We can't hit on that but we will. No. So happy birthday, MC Delight. Also celebrating their birthday this week, the one and only Summer Walker, a very hot R&B singer right now. Summer Walker did the duet with Usher.
Yes.
As well as many other solo songs. Summer Walker celebrating her birthday this week, as is Ed O'Neill. Do you know who he is?
No.
He's the man who plays...
He's the football guy. Oh, no.
Yes.
Oh, is he?
Yes.
Yeah, I
he's
guess
the dad, Mr. Bundy from Married with Children.
Ted Bundy.
Oh, okay.
Not Ted Bundy. No. He is not a serial killer. No.
Ed. No.
Al. His name is Al. Sure. Oh my God. So Mr. Ed O'Neill. Okay, so that of course was Young Guns featuring Rel with No Better Love. Now this is 112 with It's Over Now. Remember this jam? Okay, also celebrating this week, supermodel Alessandra Ambrosio walked the runways of the world, including Victoria's Secret. She was one of the models that used to wear the great big wings. Remember those back in the day?
Nope, never had them.
Okay. So also, drag legend Plastique Tiara celebrating their birthday this week. Also, reggaeton star Manuel Turizo is celebrating his birthday this week, as is Shannon Doherty.
Is she still alive?
Of course she is. I know she had a bout. I think it was breast cancer or ovarian cancer.
Oh.
Can't remember which one, but I think she went beat it. I really do. Or maybe she's in some form of remission.
Mm.
But anyway, she is.
I just haven't heard about her for a long time.
Yeah, she's celebrating her birthday this week. Of course, she was on Charmed. She was the lead villain in Jawbreaker. She was also on Little House on the Prairie.
She was on Little House on the Prairie, yes.
And so many other, I mean, just an actress all over the place. To the one and only David Letterman, one of the kings of late night TV.
He was from Nebraska.
David Letterman was?
Yes. Wasn't he?
No, I didn't. I thought he was from Indiana.
Oh.
I don't know, maybe. I will have to see. We have to look that up. And also, happy birthday.
What did you put in my coat?
I know. What did you put in that coat? So share it with us. Also, to... action movie star Jackie Chan.
Oh,
Mr. Chan.
Nice.
Yes, he is celebrating his birthday this week, as is actor extraordinaire Russell Crowe.
Ooh, I love Russell Crowe.
I do too. Of course, The Gladiator, my favorite movie by him.
Ooh.
Love Russell Crowe. And one and only, I don't know, jazz R&B legend Billie Holiday is celebrating her birthday posthumously, of course. And then also the second half of the group, Mr. John Oates. Of course, Daryl Hall was usually the...
Are they still fighting?
Yes, they are. They are. They do not speak, and he sued him, so that's out there. Also, happy birthday to Lil Nas X.
Oh, okay.
Hasn't heard anything from him recently.
He's the Old Town Road.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, so many things. He had a really big, probably 21, 22. That's when he really, really blew up. Yeah, so Lil Nas X celebrating this week, as is Julian Lennon, the singing son of the one and only John Lennon.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, has his own career. Also, Kristen Stewart. Do you know her?
Yes.
She is most famously known for playing Bella Swan on the Twilight series. Yes. So were you Team Edward or were you Team Jacob? Because I was Team Buffy. I was like, where's Buffy when you need her?
Man, I'll tell you what, it was a hard line between Team Edward or Team Jacob.
Yes.
Like there was no gray line.
Right, right. Did you have a team?
I was more so Team Jacob.
Were you?
I was kind of mad that she went down the path she did. I was like, see, that's why it... No, I'm just kidding. That's why!
Yeah, so Savannah was, of course... Team Edward. But anyway, happy birthday, Kristen Stewart. Of course, actor Alex Pettifer, he was a character actor. He was also one of the sidekicks in the original Magic Mike.
Ooh.
So yeah, he was one of the guys there. Also, Charlie Hunnam. Charlie Hunnam is another action actor. He was in that movie where there was these monsters coming out of the ocean in Los Angeles. Oh, I can't think of the name of that movie.
Is his name Charlie Hunter?
Charlie Hunnam.
Oh, Hunnam.
Hunnam. Yes, and of course that was 112 with It's Over Now. That's a nice little groove.
Is he Sons of Anarchy?
Yes, Sons of Anarchy is the TV show he is also on as well.
Oh, Pacific Rim?
Yeah, that's what it was. Yep, Pacific Rim. Okay, and then now we're moving into Maya with her song Fallen. Not Falling, Fallen. Okay. So also celebrating their birthday this week, the one and only fashion icon herself, posthumously, Miss Vivian Westwood, would have celebrated her birthday this week, as also hip-hop legend Biz Markie.
Mm.
You know, just a friend. And then, of course, to Playboy founder, Mr. Hugh Hefner.
Oh, okay.
I don't know if he was the actual founder, but I don't know. He was definitely, that was his brand and his icon for years and years, Hugh Hefner. Of course, to another fashion icon, Mr. Marc Jacobs. He's celebrating his birthday this week, as is actress Cynthia Nixon. Do you know who she is?
I do.
Who is she?
She is Miranda on Sex and the City.
Yeah, Miranda on Sex and the City. She also had a very long career as well. She was the maid on the movie Amadeus.
Really?
I don't think I've seen that.
Yeah, oh, really? Mm-hmm. Oh my gosh, you got to see it. It's one of the best movies ever.
Out.
Yeah, one of the best movies. So happy birthday, Cynthia Nixon. And then, of course, posthumously to, you know his name. You may not know what he did, but John Madden.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, very famously, because his name is still used in video games today. Madden's football, and then whatever year. Yeah. And then, of course, the last one we have, the one and only Kenneth Babyface Edmonds is celebrating his birthday this week. Okay, so Maya is singing Fallen in the background, guys. You know it's about that time. So we're going to go deep into it. In what year was the jazz legend Billie Holiday born? Billie Holiday.
I'm going to say she was born in
1908.
Okay. I'm going to follow DJ Raya's lead, and I'm going to go into 1912.
And that was actually a good move because she is 1915.
Ooh.
Yeah. She died, and I want to say it was the early 1960s or somewhere, maybe 1959. She didn't get too old.
Yeah,
you know,
she wasn't very old.
But of course, a major and huge legendary icon in the jazz world, as well as early R&B. Okay, so how old is Mr. Al Bundy, Ed O'Neill? How old is Ed O'Neill? He also was in Modern Family, but of course, everyone will always remember him for Married with Children.
How old is
Ed O'Neill? He was in a cop show, too. They did some, like, some kind of police show.
I know he scored 4 touchdowns in a high school game. I think he is probably about...
That's a good one.
And
how old is he?
77.
Best of
me. I'm going to say 79.
And actually, Sharon Teed got it right on the dot. He is 77.
Oh, on the dot.
Snaps. Okay, so that was Maya with Fallen. And now we're going into, I don't care about the controversy. I think the song is good. Baby, this is R. Kelly.
It's Nobody Like You.
Chocolate Factory.
Why, what's the controversy?
Just because it's him. Some people are like, and it's like, I don't care what he did. I like the music. So,
you
know.
Well, you care about what he did.
I mean, it's like, that's not what I'm trying to do.
You don't excuse it, but he's still a really good singer.
Yeah, the
a
music
very,
is...
very talented singer. Yeah. I always say this. I remember when he sang at Whitney Houston's funeral. It just blew you away. Absolutely amazing. So, okay. So then the next one we have is... In what year was Vivian Westwood born? Now, Vivian Westwood is a fashion icon, and of course, you might remember her because in the Sex and the City movie, Carrie wore her dress to the wedding that never happened between her and Big. That was a Vivian Westwood original. So, in what year was Vivian Westwood born? She has since passed on.
I'm gonna stick with 1908.
Gonna say 1916. 16, and by a shave, Besame is closer because she was actually born in 1941.
Oh,
yeah, she wasn't quite as old. So then, of course,
she just looked old.
Yes, the impresario of the Playboy dynasty, Mr. Hugh Hefner, and of course his MTV reality show, The Girls Next Door, is that what it was called? With the Playboy bunnies and that kind of thing.
Oh,
in what year was Mr. Hefner born?
Oh my God, I know that.
He has too passed on.
thing, did it? I didn't know he passed away.
Yeah, he passed away. I want to say in 12.
Hola. I'm going to say he was born in 1936.
36.
See, this whole time I just thought he was still kicking.
Nope.
You said 1936. Yep. So I'm going to say 1919.
He was that old? Actually, it was 1926.
Oh.
So you guys were splitting the difference there. Five away and Sharon was 10 away.
So you were closer without going over, I suppose.
Yeah. So the next one we're going to do is, how old is fashion designer Marc Jacobs?
Ooh. I've just seen that too. I'm going to say he
is very much alive.
Yes.
I'll say that.
I'm going to say he's 60.
60?
I have to get this right because my mom, she's a big fan of the Daisy Marc Jacobs, the fragrance. Is that right?
Okay.
And I got it for her. Like, it's whenever I'm able to get it as a gift, so I can't mess this up. What'd you say? 68?
Sharon Teeds, it's 60, 60.
59.
Okay, and you guys are both really close. He is 61.
Mm.
So you guys got that close there. So, okay, the last one we'll do, and we'll close out this section here. How old is David Letterman?
Oh,
79
says Bessemer.
82
says Sharon Teed. And again, no, Bessemer got it on there. He is 76. Okay, guys.
Oh, and then sorry to cut you off. You guys were wondering if he was from Nebraska or Indiana. Uh-huh. It was Indiana.
Yep. Oh, okay.
That's right. So R. Kelly's Chocolate Factory is in the background, guys. We're going to give the next song a listen because we're going to go into the weekend. This is the Rez Ride on KWTN 100.9 FM. Turn it up and tell your friends because the prize is on its way.
Together, started hanging out. You was skeptical at first, had to figure out if I was the kind of guy to try to dog you out. But I ain't that kind of guy you try to make me out. You found out when you turned to my baby. I showed them other brothers how to treat a lady. I let you drive when I ride that Mercedes. And I ain't tripping or acting shady, cause baby, you know I ain't never had nobody show me all the things that you done show me. In a special way I feel when you hold me, we gon' always be together. Baby, that's what she told me, and I believe it, cause I ain't never had nobody do me like you.
And every time I think about you, I, when you ride, when you call, when you come up, your love is amazing to me. I can't wait till I see you. I wanna be with you again. And every time you're out on the road,
I'll make a trip.
And whenever I'm doing a show,
don't you forget
that I'm your main chick. Who got that game chick? One and the same chick, the one you can hang with.
I ain't never had nobody show me all the things that you done show me. In a special way I feel when you hold me, we gon' always be together. Baby, that's what she told me, and I believe it, cause I ain't never had nobody do me like you.
You
hit the mall, pop tags, spin a few G's in. Hit the runway to a new season. It ain't nothing to spoil the one I care for. Feel like I ain't doing enough, that's when I share more. I give you this, give you that, what you need, love. You know I gotta holler at me if you need love and affection, cause I be your protection. Kinda hard job, but I do it to perfection. And you can tell that I ain't tryna let you go. I get with you when I can, so that's how I let you know. And you be tripping, cause sometimes I gotta go. But you the first one I holler to right after my shows. And I was tripping in a sense, I was tense. But my body loose around you, but I'ma do without you. I gotta get it together, say whatever. But since I met you, my life seems so better.
I ain't never had nobody show me all the things
that you didn't show me in a special way. I feel when you hold me, we gon' always be together, baby. That's what you told me, and I believe it. I ain't never had nobody do me like you.
I ain't never had nobody show me all the things that you done show me in a special way. I feel when you
That's a little bit of a throwback jam there. That is Bow Wow featuring Ciara. We played this last week, and it's called Like You. So this is The Rez Ride coming to you live on KWTN 100.9 FM. Let's get the transition. I didn't see the song in front of it, and now we're going to do The Weeknd.
Yes.
I love this song.
Me too.
Okay, guys, we're going to give you a little bit of a sample for everyone who's out there listening on KWTN 100.9 FM, terrestrial radio, or if you are joining us live, 402-922-3347 will be the line, or you can be online. And the first person to get the correct answer is going to be the winner of the t-shirt. But these are samples of the questions. We're not there yet, guys, okay?
So I have people asking.
Yes, I'm going to have the guest DJs answer this question. Yep. So it's going to be urban myth.
Okay.
So you basically have to say true or false.
Okay.
Yeah, we make things real difficult here. So in celebrities, Walter Koenig, who is better known as playing Pavel Chekhov on Star Trek, was added to the cast of Star Trek after Pravda editorialized and complained about the absence of Russians on the show. Is that true or false? So if you don't know, Pravda is one of the main newspapers of the Russian nation. I believe it's printed out of Moscow. Pravda, ironically, means truth in the Russian language. But after Pravda editorialized and complained that there were no Russians in Star Trek, was the character Chekhov added?
I'm going to say...
You can consult the 8-ball if you'd like.
I would like to consult
okay,
the 8-ball.
Yes.
Don't let me down, 8-ball. Remember last time we had a hard time looking at this? Hold on.
Oh, yeah, we needed a light because it's dark in here.
Says, my reply is no.
Okay. So it's false?
So false.
Okay, Sharon.
Okay, I'm going to consult the 8-ball,
right
too.
Right eye, right-eyed red horn.
Right eye. It says...
Right eye or correct eye?
Outlook good, so I'm going to say yes.
Okay, so the correct answer is it is true, and as Dwayne said also online, Gene Roddenberry wrote to the publication himself informing them that Chekhov's addition to the crew was coming.
So was he really Russian? Or did he just...
Walter Koenig? No, I don't believe so. No.
Or did he just play the...
He was a character.
Oh, okay.
So, yeah. Did a good accent, of course. It's pretty easy to do. Okay, so another sample question is from nature. Man is the only creature that favors his right over his left side. Is that true or false from nature? That man is the only creature that favors the right over the left.
I'll go first.
Okay.
I'm going to say false.
Okay.
I'm going to say true.
And the answer is, it is a myth. Many animals display limb dominance. Studies have shown parrots, polar bears tend to be left-footed, while many racehorses are right-legged. And also, I did see a documentary once where tigers will fight with both front paws. A marked difference between tigers and lions.
Wow.
Yeah, lions will typically only have one paw.
Swipe with one of the paws.
But tigers will attack with both. Okay, so that was The Weeknd with A Lonely Night. Now we're going into some Brandy with
Best Friend.
What
about cougars? How do they attack?
I don't know. We'll ask them tonight. Yeah. Okay, so another sample question here, guys, and then we're going to get into our first top five topic.
Okay.
Don't forget, 402-922-3347 is the text line that you will be able to text in and answer correctly
yes.
when we get to that point. So I'm giving you samples from the celebrity world. Jim Henson's tragic death in 1990 prompted Sesame Street writers to give Ernie leukemia and phase him out of the show.
What?
Is that true or false?
What?
Of course, Jim Henson was one of the main creators, if not the main creator of the Muppets. So, when
so
he died
mean.
In 1990, his death did it prompt Sesame Street writers to give Ernie leukemia so he could be phased out of the show.
False.
False.
I'm going to say false as well.
You are both correct. That is a myth. The Children's Television Workshop was denied and has denied the rumor and insists there was never a plan to phase out Ernie.
Ooh, I love Ernie.
I know. Bert and Ernie, the same-sex couple and whatever. Okay, we'll do one more. In nature, Arctic explorers have eaten steaks from frozen woolly mammoth carcasses. Myth or truth?
Ooh,
explorers
wow.
in the Arctic have eaten steaks from the frozen carcasses of woolly mammoths. Is that true or is it a myth?
I think that would be awesome. It'd probably be a little freezer burn, but I'm going to say yes.
They didn't have any baking soda then. So.
What is the phone number?
It's 402-922-3347.
Right.
And I'm going to say false.
Okay. And the answer is that is a myth. The team that discovered Berezovka, the mammoth, said they considered trying the meat, but fed it to their dogs instead. Mm. So apparently, I guess the meat did exist.
Edible.
Yeah. Oh my gosh. Could you imagine that? From, my God, how long ago was that? 10, 12,000 years ago?
Well, last night I pulled out a hamburger that was from 2022. No, I'm just kidding.
Oh my God. So we had our own little bit of woolly mammoth. Yes. Okay, guys.
Was that wool or was that? No, I'm just kidding.
I don't know. So those are the types of questions that we will be asking when you win your shirt. 402-922-3347 or go to our YouTube channel, log in, and watch what's happening live. And the first person to come up with the correct answer will win this brand new The Big Voice Radio t-shirt featuring the logo. They are literally hot off the press. They were hot in the box when Tyler brought them in. I almost said Taylor. Sorry about that, girl. But yeah, you can win that. Okay, so our top five topic of the day is in our expert opinions. We're going to give a listing of comedians.
Okay.
And so who's number five?
My number five is George Carlin.
Oh my gosh, yes.
And the only reason is because I got a record album for Christmas, and that's my introduction to him. So one day I opened it up and I put it on my record player and I start listening to it, and I thought he was corny but funny.
Oh, it was. And of course, his political comedy was absolutely biting. And what the younger generation may not know is George Carlin is the voice of the character on the movie Cars, where he was, "That's organic," when he was talking about their gasoline and stuff. He was that guy. Yeah, very good one, George Carlin. Nice. Destiny, number five.
I'm going to go with a duel.
Okay.
And these two are from Wild 'N Out.
Okay.
And I think I talked about them before, but they do, like, I haven't seen them do it in a while. I haven't watched any of the new season, but they did have a part in there where they did like a back and forth when they do the rap battle portion. Uh-huh. But I'm going to go with Chico Bean and Carlos Miller.
Okay.
I think that's his name, Carlos. But they do like a back and forth type of rap battle thing. And there's a lot of different things that segments that they do in Wild 'N Out, but they're my favorites from the show.
Hey, very good. Yeah, I love that when they would do that to one another and stuff. Of course, so this is Brandy with Best Friend, ladies and gentlemen. Coming up next is Sharon T doesn't have the aux cord, but these are songs that she wanted to hear. This is Brantley Gilbert with Bottoms Up.
Bottoms Up.
Turn the page a little bit here, guys, because we're going to go all over the place today in Rez Ride. So my number five is probably not somebody that most people know, but every time that I have heard their performance, it absolutely just had me just laughing as hard as I could, especially when there was an impersonation of Judy Garland. It's Jinx Monsoon.
Ooh.
Yes, if you've seen it, of course, when Jinx was performing on the Drag Race All-Stars, where all the winners performed together, utterly amazing, because the performance that was given with Judy Garland, because in the original appearance that Jinx did on Drag Race, there was a guest person, because they had to make over just random people and turn them in, you know, to drag and whatever. The guy claimed that he killed Judy Garland. So Jinx brought that back, and of course RuPaul and Michelle Visage remembered. They were the only ones, and they were just dying because Jinx was talking about that. "You didn't kill me, you're forgiven." And it's like, oh my gosh, it was so funny. So Jinx Monsoon is my number five. Okay, guys, don't forget, you're going to be able to win your t-shirt here pretty soon. 402-922-3347, or go to our YouTube page, log in, and find our channel under That Fire, though. And the first person to give the answer is going to be the winner. We're going to let Brantley Gilbert play out. Yep, here we go. KWTN 100.9 FM, turn it up. Bottoms Up. Yes, that is the one and only Brantley Gilbert with Bottoms Up. This is the Rez Ride coming to you live on KWTN 100.9 FM. Like I said, we're going to go all over the place today, guys. We're not going to just stick in one genre. So that was country, and now we're into some old school funk. This is the group Brick with the song Dad. Nice little cut. So don't forget, listeners, we're going to be giving away one of the brand new KWTN The Big Voice Radio t-shirts. 402-922-3347 is the text line that you will use to text your answer, or go to our YouTube channel page and go to That Fire, though, and you will be able to get there and give us that answer. And so we're giving out some sample questions here, guys. So are you ready for a few more?
Yes.
Don't forget, you can also consult the Magic 8-Ball if you need it. This is a sample question, guys. There will be something similar to this, okay? So, in the world of business, the letters in FUBU Sportswear mean for us, by us. Is that a myth or is it the truth?
The truth.
The truth, says DJ Destiny.
We like to say that up here at the Big Voice.
I'm going to consult the 80s.
Okay. Can you see it?
Yes.
Okay. It has to be straight up. Because it's got to float
cannot
to the top.
Cannot predict now.
Oh, okay.
So I'm just going to override it and say true.
It's true? The answer is is a myth.
Oh.
Early tags read Five Urban Brothers United in reference to the company's founding partners.
Okay.
Yeah, I know. I always said that too, for us, by us, and whatever else. So, yeah. So I would have got that wrong too. Okay, so the next sample question we have is from the world of movies and celebrities. The hit 90s movie Fargo is based on a true story which took place in North Dakota in the winter of 1987. Is that true or is it a myth?
It's true.
Okay.
I will consult the
ball.
The ball. All right, so we will go with definitely.
Okay, so you're both saying true?
Yes.
And the 8-Ball let you down. It is a myth. Although the movie opens with such a claim, the Coen brothers have admitted the tale is pure fiction.
Okay.
Wow.
Okay. Yeah, so then the next one that we will take out of here is... Oh my gosh, they just won't let it go. Muppets Bert and Ernie are actually a gay couple discreetly living together.
False.
False.
I'm gonna consult the magic eight ball.
Go ahead. Okay. It's right there.
So Outlook, not so good.
Okay.
False.
False. And the answer is, it is a myth. It is false. Bert and Ernie are puppets, not people, and the Children's Television Workshop empathetically states their characters are nothing more than good friends.
Buddies.
Buddies. Okay, so this is Britney Spears with I'm a Slave for You, guys. So are you ready?
Okay.
Okay. 402-922-3347. The time is now. This is the question, guys, and we got to get it quick. From the world of celebrities. Although Elvis spelled his middle name A-R-O-N, the king's gravestone contains the more common spelling and reads Elvis Aaron Presley with two A's. Is this true or false? The first correct answer will win the t-shirt. Is it true or false? On the king Elvis Presley's gravestone, is his middle name spelled with two A's or the way he spelled it with one? Because we're blind, that's why. Okay, so Dwayne says it's true. Is that the first one?
Let's see.
Yep.
Yep.
I think it is. Okay, and the answer is ding, 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 ding. Yes, it is true. The error has led many fans to believe the king is still alive. So congratulations, Dwayne. You are the winner of our KWTN 100.9 FM, the Big Voice Radio t-shirt. So you'll have to send us your information on how we're going to get it. Or you can drive up here.
Yep, come smooth.
It'll be waiting for you at the front desk. No, just kidding. So congratulations, guys. Don't forget, we're going to be giving these out throughout all the other programs and in very different ways and stuff. And so you will have another chance to get one if today wasn't your day. And so that's what we're going to do there. So let's throw a couple more of these questions out here, guys, because we're going to be moving in to the love line. Okay?
All right.
So from the world of celebrities, Al-Qaeda supporters in Afghanistan carried posters of Osama bin Laden pictured with Bert of Sesame Street. Is this true?
I'm going to say false.
Okay. What all these Sesame Street questions are. It's like, and then Bert and Ernie, gosh.
False.
It's false? Okay, the answer is true.
Ooh.
Pictures of the protest and the protesters were carried by international wire services, including Reuters and the Associated Press.
Oh.
Okay. The next one that we have, a couple seconds here left. John Bunyan wrote most of Pilgrim's Progress while in jail.
I thought he was like a fictional, or like a
that's
from
Paul
the book.
Bunyan. Yes, Paul Bunyan and the Big Blue Ox.
I don't know Bunyans. So
is it true or false?
Mr. Bunyan is true.
The answer is
false.
True. Oh. Bunyan served more than 12 years for preaching without a license.
Oh.
I know, isn't that crazy? Okay, guys. You know what that means? Because we're here.
Love line. Take it away, Shanty.
Love.
Sing it.
Exciting and new. Come aboard.
What are they doing?
We're expecting you.
Do you think you could karaoke this?
Life's no, sweetest, I can't even karaoke.
Okay, just that first line.
Let it flow. Because what does it do, right-eyed red horn?
It floats back to you.
Love Boat. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, that is the one and only Jack Jones singing the Love Boat theme from the wonderfully talented multicast event that was the classic television show from the 1970s and 1980s. Of course, the captain played by Gavin MacLeod. Do you remember any of the other actors' names? One of them was a congressman from this side of Iowa.
Yeah. I don't remember what his name was, though. It's an open
smile. His name was Ted. Or was it Ted?
Bundy.
No.
Every time.
What is it with these serial killers? No. Grandy. Remember?
Al Grandy.
No. Anyway, so we're going to let it go there. Okay, guys. So we're going to get into the, the love line here on KWTN 100.9 FM. This is where callers text, write, scream, holler, write letters, get us the message. But there are some good ones that we have here today. So let's dive right in. Of course, that is now Busta Rhymes featuring Mariah. Mm-hmm. I Know What You Want.
I love this song.
Okay. Up first, then we have, in quote, or in parentheses, Hi, Maintenance Man.
Oh,
all right. And what she writes is, girl, and she actually wrote, so there were M's in a row. Girl, he is more pampered than I am, exclamation point. He knows our petty staff by name and they know him. He knows the salon staff by name, and they know him, and he even has a regular masseur. Girl, help me cope with this because I've never been with a guy who is that in touch with that side of himself. So basically,
did Junior write this?
So basically, she's used to having, I guess, a roughneck or a guy that really doesn't take care of anything on his body. And so now the guy that she's with is super, super comfortable with the pedicure, the manicure, the masseuse, and the folks at the salon. So she wants some advice. Could you handle it, or would it bother you at all, or dump him?
Run for the hills. No, but I think that she should embrace it because, yeah, he's like one in a million, so.
Okay. Yes, and Dwayne, we will hold it until powwow. Okay.
I took a bite.
Oh, sorry. So while you're chewing there then, because we're here, you know, we're speaking, so we need our mouth. Okay, so.
No, but I don't mean to like say that most guys aren't in touch with their femininity or feminine. How would you say that? Femininity.
Okay.
But I think that it would be a nice little bonding, something that you could bond with each other over.
Okay. So
for me.
Oh, go ahead.
Okay.
Are you ready?
Yes, all right. I am ready.
Spit it.
Okay, so for me, I don't look at it that way. I think if a man is willing to take care of himself, he's gonna take care of you.
Yes.
And I think that,
so you're telling her to go with it?
Yeah, I would go with it. And you know, if he's gonna go get a pedicure and then say, let's go jump in so you can get your pedicure, mm-hmm. get your manicure, get your massage, you know. And,
all that.
And do you think this song fits the question?
No. But I don't know. I don't think of it as a bad thing because you don't want someone stank and hairy and real gross toenails and real black fingernails. They're like, come here, baby, let me scratch you. I'm like, what's under them nails, you know? And then kind of clean it out, and then little worms crawl away.
Worms? Oh my God. Okay. Any other advice for high maintenance men?
Go with it. Don't be upset about it.
So my advice, girl, is actually going to be very much along that lines, girl. If he's paying, ride the ride, baby.
Well,
sit in the passenger seat. Okay, so that, of course, was Busta Rhymes and Mariah Carey featuring the Flip Mode Squad with I Know What You Want. Now some more Busta Rhymes with Put Your Hands Where My Eyes Could See. Okay, so the next one that we have then is Weeha's Wingman. It's a little bit of an explanation here, okay? So, what she writes is, I gave a DM guy away. So, She was DMing with this guy and then she gave him away. He just got two and then she wrote dot dot dot. I don't know what. It just too much. Now he's seeing my girl. Not my bestie, but my girl. And I have to say, I'm really not okay with it for some reason. Even though, yes, I pushed him away, I just can't seem to handle the fact that he's with her. And then she went there. Help me get him back.
Sorry, girl, you snooze, you lose. Just kidding.
It's true, though, it is. So she gave him away because, I don't know, she felt some kind of way or thought something wasn't there or whatever, but now he has basically hooked up with one of her girlfriends, not her bestie, she made that clear, but she just can't handle it, and now she wants him back.
Okay, Weehan, listen to Auntie.
Okay, here we go. Crack your knuckles.
Oh, okay. So first, you DM him and say, what's going on between you and my friend? Because I'm ready now. And just put it all out there. Send some pictures and ask him to send you a picture. And if he does, then it's on. Just go for it.
Because it don't is play, act up season.
Yeah, don't play games no more. If you want it, get it.
If you want it, get it.
Yes.
Okay.
Bottom line.
Okay. All right. So my advice is going to be also something very much along that line. Is like, you know, if you want to be known as that girl, then go ahead and do it, girl. Go ahead and do it. Do whatever you need to do. Make a fool out of yourself and all that kind of stuff.
Yes.
So.
Do it.
But I got to say, you know, it's like you always want what you see and you don't want what you have.
Ooh. Wow.
Like I said, it's, you know, the
that
best the best worst advice this side of Hatchet Hill. So it's like,
yeah.
We're not always on the listener's side. You know, it's like, if they're those two are happy, and it's like,
shoot, all the girls I know would just go for it.
Okay.
We were going in there, I was like, you know that one saying where it's like, no end in giving?
Ooh, yeah, let's bring back the phrases. Oh my gosh, you know, some people would probably can't say that. Can't say that on the radio. You
say all whatever. You heard was just kidding.
Okay, that of course was Busta Rhymes, Put Your Hands Where My Eyes Could See. Now this is Sheila E. with Love Bizarre.
Oh, I just want to listen to this song because I love it when she's playing that drums.
The tambourine.
Yeah.
I always did just like just listening to this.
Of course, Prince wrote it.
Mm-hmm. You can hear it. You can hear his influence on it.
Okay, so any more advice for Wingman? Weehaw Wingman?
No, that's. Just go after it and get it.
Okay. Okay. So then the last one we have then, guys, is Act Up Pup. And what she writes is, I'm a listener, and yes, indeed, you guys are right. The season is here. It is time for Act Up Season.
Ooh.
She was very adamant in her agreement. So now she's with this guy. He's been acting salty for some reason and has been taking it out on my dog. He's not being actually abusive, but he ignores her. He doesn't replenish the water dish, or he'll just not do anything to help. So her question is, because it is act up season, should she actually kick her man out because of the dog?
Do it, girl. Just do it.
I agree. Dump him.
Dump him immediately?
Dump him.
Yes. And find yourself a man that likes your dog.
Yep.
And actually wants to be a part of your life.
Will.
Yes. Yes.
Okay.
Because those dogs get thirsty.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, guys, that has been the love line, and I don't think we're going to get any better than that. So we'll give the rest of this song a listen. Miss Sheila E., of course, with Prince in the background. Love Bizarre. KWTN 100.9 FM. You seen it?
No.
Do you know who it is?
No, I just know the song from Dirty Dancing. The Ronettes?
It is not Ronnie Spector, no.
The Shirelles?
Yep.
Ooh, yeah.
Yes, this is the Rez Ride coming to you live on KWTN 100.9 FM, listeners. And in the background, we are going all the way back into the golden age of rock and roll. And this is the Shirelles with Will You Still Love Me Tomorrow?
Nice.
Okay, guys, so we're talking about our top five topic of the day, and we're talking about our favorite live and stand-up comedians. And so we did number five. Are you ready for number four?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, who wants to go first?
I'll go first.
Okay.
So mine, let me line us up here for our live streamers. But mine is going to go, we had some celebrities pop in the studio. I want to say this was, I should have left it up. It was in 2022.
Okay.
We had James and Ernie pop in. I want to say the YCIC brought them to Winnebago and they had an event. So they did some like stand up and some, they had an event over at the Land of Wellness. I don't remember what it was for, but I know that they brought them in and they did stop in the studio here. So James and Ernie, and the reason why is because they even made a point to kind of roast me a little bit. But it was funny, so I was laughing.
I'm always a fan of that, I have to say, you know, because I don't know why some people can't handle it.
Yeah.
You know, because it's like when I would love to be roasted, but you got to be good at it. You can't just be mean.
Yeah.
You know, it's like, yeah there's got to be some little sting to it, mm-hmm. but it's got to be funny. So, yeah. Okay. Number four, Sharon T.
My number four is this lady. I just love her. And even when she starts talking, it's Wanda Sykes.
Yes.
I love her.
Yeah, she is absolutely crazy.
She just reminds me of how I think I would be if I was a comedian. Just rugged, that one.
Bold and brash.
Yeah.
Okay, guys. So now that was, of course, the Shirelles with Will You Still Love Me Tomorrow. Do you know who this is?
When the twilight is gone, you come into my heart.
Oh.
And here in my heart you will say.
Sounds so familiar.
While I pray.
Oh my God.
Oh, I would have never guessed.
My Roy Orbison.
No, but
no?
I can see where you're getting it.
Oh. Oh my God, I know this song too.
At the end of the day,
I can't think of it.
In a dream that's divine.
Am I gonna say old crap when you?
You probably know it.
My prayer.
The name of the song
is a rapture in blue.
Oh my God.
With the world far away.
Is Dwayne saying it?
And your lips close to mine.
Do you know who this song is? Or who this singing, who the singer in the song is?
Do you know?
Oh, I can't think. I know it's not Elvis.
While you're thinking about that, so Wanda Sykes is your number four.
Yes.
Leading up to the part that I want to pay attention to. So my number four is going to be the one and only Dave Chappelle. Dave Chappelle. Chappelle Show, I miss it so much. You would not be able to watch that on TV today because they would never get it out of the gate because people would say, never. And it's like, but so many skits, so many acts, especially when he had Rick James and Charlie Wilson. And it's like, oh my gosh. I posted one of those today on my own social media because it was so funny. But this is The Platters. And the song is My Prayer. And right here, guys, listen. Right here.
At the end of my prayer.
All I kept thinking was, oh, yes, I'm a great pretender. something
they
like
were
that.
The same singers, so Ooh. The Great Pretender. Okay, so, and the reason why I wanted to play that, guys, is because I've always wanted to put that on the show. I challenge any male singer today to do that.
Oh yeah,
yeah, that was beautiful.
Do you think they could? Can you think of a singer that could do that? A male singer today that could do that?
I think someone who could come close would be Adam Lambert.
Do you think so?
Yeah. Okay. He's got the range to do it in the vibrato.
Okay. Do you think a male singer? Can you think of a male singer that can hit that and do it?
I'm gonna say Abel Tesfaye. Maybe The Weeknd. Maybe with the right day, the right moment. Yeah.
Okay. I kind of wondered. You know, I think it would be a stretch, but I think Bruno Mars could get it.
Maybe.
Yeah. So now, listening in the background, of course, that was The Platters. And yes, they were The Great Pretender, as well as so many other Golden Age hits. Yeah. Oh my gosh. But that was the prayer, my prayer, excuse me. Now this is Burna Boy featuring 21 Savage, Sitting on Top of the World. I don't know who the lady's voice is. So of course, we're doing our comedians. We did number 4 because of time. Let's jump in. Do you ready for number 3?
Yeah.
Okay, so who is number 3?
Go ahead. I'll go number 3. For me is Sharon Teed's number 4, Wanda Sykes.
Nice.
She used to be on a show, right?
She was on a lot of TV shows. That one, the New Adventures of Old Christine. She was like one of the business partners. She was also, I think she was on Ellen's show.
Yes.
And I mean, she, yeah.
Yeah,
she
was, there was some that I used to watch when I was younger, but that's how I like came across her. And yeah, I just like her.
Wanda Sykes,
yeah.
Number 4.
There's some videos that are out that you can watch her do her show. Man, I just love them.
Yeah, she's
my number 3 is Kevin Hart.
Okay.
Yes.
Little Kevin Hart.
Yes.
Yeah. What did you like of his?
I just like, again, if I was a little Kevin Hart, that's how I would be. The topics and stuff that he chooses.
Yeah, okay.
And then I would say those things, and I would talk about those things.
Okay, no, good one.
You know, because I'm real little and petite. No, I'm just kidding.
Okay, what is in that Coke? Okay, no, good ones. So my number 3, of course, is going to be one of the titans and one of the absolute legends, Mr. Eddie Murphy.
Oh, nice. Yes.
I remember seeing Delirious, and then when he came out with Raw, and of course, I was a teenager, so Delirious was like, a young teenager at that. So, and then of course, you know, Delirious and Raw, and I can still quote quite a bit of him. That's why I know what he was great, because it still lives in my
memory.
Yeah,
I forgot all about
him.
I just, my mind wasn't going that way.
Because of course, you remember Goonie Goo Goo. Mm-hmm. And Aunt Bunny falling down the stairs. Oh, Lord, help me, Jesus. Oh, my gosh, dropped my clipboard. Okay, so my number 3 is him. Okay, guys, let's give this song a listen. This is another new one. This is Bryson Tiller featuring Victoria Monet. Rez Ride, KWTN 100.9 FM. New music, turn it up.
Mm-hmm.
He asked if he could grab. She talk slitch, I suppose, right up until I right on the nose, she tryin' to facilitate this night on Rosé. It's a go, go, go. Gave her the disclaimer, don't fall in love. She gave me that persuasion, not for high on drugs. I'm finna take her somewhere, tell these don't come. It ain't no after party, just me and shawty.
He's staring at me like he want this persuasion. And I'm looking right back at him like I want some of that decision tonight.
Tonight.
He asked if he could grab. I'm on 10 in that zone. No, baby, not like friend. I'm trying bonjour, hip
Perry did wrong. They like he did wrong. Still singing along. Here go the disclaimer, don't fall in love, skin. That persuasion up it high on drugs, feeling. Take a song and be one-on-one. No after party, just me and Shawty.
He's staring at me like he want this persuasion. And I'm looking right back at him like I want some of that decision tonight.
There you go, ladies and gentlemen. Of course, that was previously Bryson Tiller featuring Victoria Monet with a song called Persuasion. And I like it because they are very, very witty with the lyrics, especially if you listen to it. Okay, guys. So, of course, INXS, new sensation, Michael Hutchence and the Fellas introducing We Are Going to Stay in This Vibe. Bryson Tiller released his new album about 2 weeks ago, I think, maybe a week or so. It hasn't been out very long. And so we're going to pull another song from that album. So this is his song called Outside, but they're both brand new music. So give them a listen, guys. New Sensation Thursday coming to you live on KWTN 100.9 FM. Turn them up, guys, because here we go.
White nail polish, 10 toes down. Shawty, don't look down. Tattoo peeking through the seat door. Yeah. Body critical, I see you. I see you. Used to be in love, now your life, Cupid. Hate to be a wreck, stunning, feel stupid. Thumbing through the ground, trying to figure out where you've been. All I need to know is that you're outside. Watch your real time, way too live. Easily adjusted to your new life. Since you let loose, you've been too tight. Tight. No place to unknown plans. You don't need a man, you got your own plans. Don't keep money, these grown bands. Had to wake them up, they sleeping. So good, gotta sleep in. Arch your back and knees in. Bring them in. Enough. Way too many fall in your direction. Choices I test and just selective.
Yeah, that too swole and I'm trying to grab that. If you get too close, tell him back, back.
He been calling your phone, we don't call back.
Let him know it's his fault. Stupid, coming through the ground, trying to figure out where you've been. All I need to know is that you're outside. Watch your real time, why you too live? Easily adjust it to your new life. Since you let loose, you've been too tight. Tight. I came here alone. I wanna take a bag home. Wanna show us some real ones. Hey, hey, I'ma call you on the phone.
You have it, ladies and gentlemen, our new sensation song for New Sensation Thursday, Bryson Tiller, off of his self-titled album. Bryson Tiller, that is a song called Outside. What'd you think?
You liked it?
Yeah, the beat is from that the Ying Yang Twins, right?
Mm-hmm. I think so.
I cannot think of the name though. But I like
myself, it. I don't know. it's just not my cup of tea.
Not your vibe?
Yeah, I'm just like, I like the new Luke Bryan instead.
We'll have to look into that, because honestly, I don't think I've heard any of it.
Yeah.
So,
but I mean, I could listen to it, you know, I wouldn't have to turn it off, because there's been songs that I just can't listen, and I'm just like, oh God, and turn it down.
Well, the last two songs we played, of course, were from Bryson Tiller's new album. So the first one, like I said, was Persuasion featuring Victoria Monet, and then Outside by himself.
Mm-hmm.
So which one did you like, the first one or the second
one? I think I like the first one better.
The slower vibe?
I like the first one too.
Okay. Oh, nice. Bryson Tiller, New Sensation Thursday. Of course, now in the background, ladies and gentlemen, the Black Eyed Peas with Meet Me Halfway.
I like Black Eyed Peas.
I always did like this song.
Me too.
It just had that hook.
It's like a timeless track.
Mm-hmm.
There you go.
The rap, her song, her singing.
Girl, I travel around the world and even sail the seven seas.
Love it.
Across the universe and go to other galaxies. Just tell me where to go, just tell me where you want to be.
It'd be like you're somewhere and the song comes on and you're just like ready to go dance and like looking for your friend and let's go. Yeah. Well, not me, because I'm old.
Anyway,
I'd bust a hip or something.
I suppose. We'll leave it at that. Okay, guys. So we've been talking about our top five topic of the day, which is, in our opinions, comedians. And we're talking kind of the stand-up style. They can be in movies and they can do other projects, of course, but they should have a very strong stand-up presence. So we did number five, number four, number three. But we do want to throw in some honorable mentions, because the list, when I was doing mine, man, I could probably triple this list easy. So honorable mentions out there that didn't make the list?
For me, it's really hard to try to choose, you know, just because.
Sure.
But the comedians that I like, they have to have my sense of humor. I'm true. Not that dry, corny, you know, whatever. I'm just like, but so a couple years ago we did a comedy show over at the Iron Horse, and we invited this guy to come over. His name was Jack Wilhite, and he did the Jack Wilhite rock and roll comedy.
Okay.
Where he during the course of his show he sings all of these guys songs while he's playing the guitar, but then he goes in and he changes his costume.
Mm-hmm.
So he becomes all of these different people, like Aretha, Prince, and I can't even remember all of them, but it was a really good show. And he goes all over the United States, and I just follow him and just kind of see what he's doing and if he adds new people. But he was a really good show, and he's probably known, but he's not as well known as, you know, some of the ones that we're mentioning. So that's one of my honorable mentions.
Any others?
I would probably have to say mine would be yours. Your last one as an honorable mention.
Eddie Murphy?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Wouldn't even make the list.
No, he didn't make my list, but after you start talking about him, then I remembered.
Yeah.
But.
Well, he's, of course, much more the movie star now.
Yeah.
You know, that type of thing. But, of course, his stand-up, that's really where he started.
So, yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Any other honorable mentions? DJ Bestmate?
I had to go through real quick because I was like, I want to get their names right.
Okay.
So Saturday Night Live.
Okay.
Okay.
Adam Sandler.
Oh, yeah.
Maya Rudolph.
Mm-hmm.
Will Ferrell. Tina Fey. Mm.
I don't know if Tina ever did stand up. I wouldn't be surprised. I just never saw it.
Whenever,
but of course, she's funny as hell.
What's that movie? There's a movie called Taxi?
Yeah.
You guys know what I'm talking about?
Yes.
I don't.
I don't know who she's. I can't think of it. I don't even know. I'm probably chopping it up.
Because I remember that with, well, the Taxi I remember was with
Queen Latifah.
Queen Latifah, mm-hmm. And Jimmy Fallon.
Okay, yeah, I might be mixing it up then. But okay. Yeah, those are mine.
Okay. Those are good ones, though.
Yeah, good ones. So. Oh my gosh. What's this remind you of?
The New Moon, or. What is that called? Team Albert.
Not quite. This, of course, is the song. It's called Full Moon by the group called The Black Ghosts. It is off of the Twilight original movie soundtrack. Mm. This is the song that they play when Bella is leaving Phoenix.
Oh.
Yes, and she's on her way to Forks to find the loves of her life. Because every boy looks for a troubled, mentally unstable girl.
And every girl looks for
a pale, pasty white guy.
Or a troubled Indian guy.
Yes, with daddy issues.
Mom and dad issues.
I know.
Oh my gosh, and anger issues as well. Oh my god. You can really break it down. It doesn't live well in today's society, you have to say that. Okay, guys, so my honorable mentions, like I said, there's quite a few. You may not know him, but it's a man named Mark Normand. He's got that extremely witty banter. Now, he's not the guy out there doing like the live, you know, really animated comedy, but he is sharp as a tack and just will whip any phrase or anything down. He's absolutely wonderful. Mark Normand, you should look him up because he's all over social media as well.
Okay.
So him, and then of course everyone's favorite recently, Matt Rife.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So Matt Rife did not make my list.
Really? Okay. Yep.
I'll have
him
to tell
on
you.
The screen, Mark Normand.
Actually, who did make my list?
Okay.
Ooh. But well.
Oh
we,
no!
We're
doing
yet.
Honorable mentions.
Yes.
So then the other ones, I know some people are going to be slapping, but what? Chris Rock. He didn't make my list, but I wanted to mention him.
He made my list.
Okay, that's good. That's good. Then he was one of the head writers for Saturday Night Live. His name is John Mulaney.
Oh.
You ever see his stand-up? It is just wickedly funny. Because there's nothing is sacred, and he, yeah, it's just like he just rip into anything.
Do you think Jimmy Fallon is funny?
Sometimes.
Sometimes?
Yeah.
Or do you think he doesn't have good writers?
Well, no, he has excellent writers. It's just that his comedy is more, I guess, physical. You know?
That's true.
Yeah, and then he adds in a lot of music. And then the other ones are Cat Williams. Remember Cat Williams?
Oh, yes.
K-A-T-T, little short guy and stuff. I always liked his comedy, and I've seen a couple of his shows and stuff. Cat Williams. Yeah.
Cat Williams is hilarious.
Yes. He's been in several movies and stuff as well, but he's had his comedy stand-ups and all that kind of stuff. But I wanted to throw him on the honorable mention list. And then the final honorable mention that I have is Amy Schumer.
Oh, yeah, she is hilarious.
Yes. Just irreverent, and then also roasts herself as well. Ooh-hoo. It's like, yeah, it's so crazy. I absolutely love her. She's just sickeningly good.
Yes,
some people say she's not funny. I was like, I think she is. Okay, so that is our honorable mentions, guys, and that was Full Moon by the Black Ghosts.
What did I say? New Moon?
Yes. No, the song is Full Moon, but New Moon was the sequel.
Oh, okay.
So now this is who, Sharon?
Oh, this is Blake Shelton with Sangria.
Yep. So you have the aux chord here. Okay, guys. So before we get into our other ones, as you guys know, we always try to give some of the additional information or did you know or a little bit of weirdness.
You know?
So I do have some here, okay?
Is it going to be scary ones like last time?
No. I don't think so anyway. Just more of like oddity. Okay, so the first one that I have is, did you know that on the set of the movie Resident Evil, so Mila Jovovich was basically the heroine, and of course it was about zombies and dead people. Resident Evil, it's based on a video game. Okay, so on the set of that movie, 16 actors fell from a platform that broke. The zombie costumes and makeup that they were wearing made it extremely difficult for the EMTs to determine was the injury real or not. Can you imagine that?
Yeah,
you
know, that'd be real stressful.
Yeah, so you're on the movie set
as
a zombie. So obviously they're going to have, you know, false prosthetics and make you look like, you know, your guts have fallen out and all this other kind of stuff. So when these 16 actors were injured in real life, the EMTs had a hard time
I hope they got a Grammy for it. Or not a Grammy.
Well, apparently from the other detail, luckily none of the injuries were too serious.
Oh.
But again, it was notable because they're dressed as zombies. Mm-hmm. And they are supposed to be messed up.
Just kind of customized their outfit.
Yes, yep. So that is that one. Then the next one is, are you aware of the EDM group Daft Punk?
Yes.
They're these guys, they wear these helmets, and they're kind of like DJs slash performers and stuff. You've probably seen them or whatever. But Daft Punk, the helmets that they wear were inspired by a 1974 movie called Phantom of Paradise. And the reason why Daft Punk wears those helmets is because the characters in that 1974 movie had similar helmets, and they basically took their inspiration from that.
Cool.
A lot of that stuff happens around the world, so
just yep. One more okay. Time.
So, as a little bit of oddity then, did you know that until the 1940s, when the switch occurred, the colors for children and babies especially, blue and pink, pink was for boys and blue was for girls? An article in the New York Times in 1918 was describing basically the fashion for babies, and they were saying that pink is a stronger color, therefore it belongs to boys, and blue, being more delicate, belongs to girls.
Wow, interesting.
Can you imagine that now though? Because what do you, when you see pink and blue, do you associate it with the genders?
I don't, because many guys wear pink now.
Let me rephrase that. If you saw a baby in pink or a baby in blue, would you assume it's gender?
Yeah, I would. Yeah.
No, I wouldn't.
Oh, you would too.
Just because of how all the clothes and everything are made now. They're not really...
They're wearing yellow.
Neutral.
You can't tell.
Yeah. I mean, agreed. I guess it's just because of how society is now that... they're not looking to place any one thing toward one.
True.
And so there's a lot more pink for boys and then a lot more blues for girls.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, no, very much so. Okay, so now that was, of course, Blake Shelton with Sangria. And now this is... Who? Jason Aldean featuring Carrie Underwood. Underwear. If I Didn't Love You.
If I Didn't Love You, yeah.
Okay. So the next one that I have then is, did you know that Hawaii didn't become a state until 18 years after the Pearl Harbor bombing?
Yes, I knew that.
Yes.
Yeah. That's just kind of one of those strange things. People think America was attacked, but at the time it was just a military base and Hawaii was a nation upon itself.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. That's what I was taught in school.
Right.
And then nowadays, it seems like people aren't being taught that.
Very much
in history.
True. Okay, mm-hmm. So the next one that I have then, Mariah Carey was rejected from a New York City co-op when she tried to purchase an $8 million condo within the facility. The co-op board rejected her because she showed up with an entire entourage of people and acted very weird. They didn't want her there.
Gee,
I believe it.
So... $8 million for a condo in New York City.
They probably had her on that chair pushing her with her tiara on
a carriage.
Well, you always see her. It's like she doesn't walk steps on her own. And it's like, girl, can you even walk?
We've seen her walk.
I know, but it's like, anyway.
She had two bodyguards and smelled delicious when she walked by us that time. You know what? That a smell will make me think about her just because when we went to go see her, and like she was walking down the aisle on the side of us, she came down from the top and was walking down, and he just pushed me out into the aisle where she was coming. But then that was the first thing I could do was smell her cologne, and I have that cologne, but I don't like it on me. So
So Mariah Carey was rejected from her co-op. So here's some strange little tidbits of did you know that there is pickle flavored cotton candy?
Yes.
I did not know that.
Yeah, would you eat it?
I wouldn't.
They have it at the $5 store.
$5?
Or below $5.
Oh, yeah, five and below.
Okay. And then also, did you know that there is peep flavored Pepsi.
I've seen that.
I know. I don't like Pepsi anyway, but...
I don't like Pepsi either.
Why would you even add that? Even more sugar?
There was Pepsi and they have another one that's kind of random. Oh, no, it's not too random. It was like cotton candy or something.
Oh, okay. Yep, peep flavored Pepsi. Did you know, you know what an icy is? Those either blue or red kind of...
With the polar bears?
Yeah. There is icy cereal.
What?
Yeah.
No, I did not know that.
Me neither.
Icy flavored cereal. Of course, Jason Aldean and Carrie Underwood with If I Didn't Love You. Now, this is a remake. This is Brooks and Dunn taking on songs of the Eagles. This is Best of My Love.
Ooh.
They do a good job. Okay. Also, did you know, this was the funny one, that there is a Dorito eyeshadow palette?
No, I did not.
So you know the coloring that's on Doritos.
Yes.
So, yeah, there is an eyeshadow palette modeled after
Doritos.
Me too. It's like they're making flavors for everything. They got visuals for all kinds of stuff. Yes. They're covering all the bases.
Yeah. And did you know it is available on Amazon, but there is a rock guitar shaped cheese grater. So when you're grating your cheese, it's like you're strumming the guitar.
Oh my God. Innovative.
Yes, of course. And then next one, did you know that they make raincoats for your sneakers?
Yes.
The models on them are typically wearing some form of Jordan.
Yes.
And yeah. So they basically cover
but
them.
But they advertise those on like the powwow websites to put over your moccasins.
Okay.
To keep them.
Okay. Let's see.
Okay.
She's like, all we had was those store bags.
I know. Right, yeah. All we had was Wonder Bags or butternut bread.
Your Jordans are getting ruined. Also, have you ever, and the last one, have you ever heard of the Impossible Puzzle?
No.
Is it supposed to be like a flower and then how you turn them?
No.
I've seen something recently about
this. Now typically a jigsaw puzzle, of course, is a picture or an image that is basically cut up, that's why they call it jigsaw, because that's how they're cut up. In the Impossible Puzzle, the jigsaw pieces still remain, however they are all made of clear plastic. There is no image to create, so you have to basically find each individual piece as it fits together without any visual guidance.
I did a Chiquita banana one time, and it was just all the yellow,
mm-hmm.
and then it just had that blue
Chiquita
sign, but that was hard to do.
Okay, so that's a little bit of that, did you know? And then also, did you know that Stone Cold Steve Austin, the wrestler,
yes,
got his name from drinking tea? The story goes is that his girlfriend, who became his wife, at the time said, yelling at him, "Hurry up and drink your tea before it goes stone cold." He liked it and kept the name.
His ears perked up.
Yeah, so he became Stone Cold Steve Austin. Yes, and then the last one that we have is, did you know that a cartoon was created, produced, and ready to be aired in 1986? But the NASA Challenger explosion occurred, and the TV network immediately pulled it from its shelves, and it never aired. The cartoon was called Young Astronauts.
Oh.
Yep.
Isn't there a cartoon called something Astronauts now, Young Astronauts?
Maybe, but back then, I remember where I was. I think it was either in 7th or 8th grade, but I remember we were watching it, and then all of a sudden it blew up.
Damn.
I hate to say that because those people died, but it was like, bam. And there we were watching it in class.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Like in real time?
Yeah, yay. On TV. They brought the TV card in and stuff. It was one of those days.
Yeah, because they were launching it. And it was, there was a few clouds out and stuff, but it was going. And then all of a sudden, because I used to watch them all the time. You know, we only had 3 channels back in the day, 4, right. 9, and 14.
Mm. I forgot what I was looking up.
Young Astronauts? I thought there was something or some type of cartoon called that, but maybe not.
No problem with that. So that is the weirdness and did you know that we have for the program today. And of course, that was Brooks and Dunn taking on Songs of the Eagles. The album is called Common Thread, The Songs of the Eagles, and that was their version of Best of My Love. Did you like it?
I did
too. You know, it's hard to
take on somebody as awesome as the Eagles and stuff, but they certainly did.
I wonder how the Eagles would do with Neon Moon.
I don't know. Do you know this one?
Yes. Love in the First Degree.
Yep. So Alabama and Friends is the album, and this is where other artists take on songs of Alabama. This is Luke Bryan with Love in the First Degree.
I could hear Luke Bryan.
Let's give it a listen, guys. This is the Rez Ride, KWTN 100.9 FM. There you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Luke Bryan taking on Alabama, Love in the First Degree. Love it, son. Love it.
As much as I love Luke Bryan, I think Alabama still did a better.
I have to agree with you. Luke did not get them there, I have to say. Cause
yeah. I mean, he was just karaoke in it to me.
He gave his best shot.
Yeah.
So now, next up, guys, we have the Little River Band with the song Lonesome Loser. We had a request for songs from the 70s. Do you know the song?
I do.
Okay, so our top five topic of the day is comedians, especially the stand-ups, in our opinion. So we're up to number two. Who is ready for number two?
I'm ready for number two. I chose Chris Rock for my number two.
Okay.
I just like his sense of humor and even how he took that famous slap in the face and how he, you know, just kind of went with it and everything. Because if somebody came up and slapped me like that, there would have been hands going back.
No,
but he,
yeah,
I think he just controlled himself and everything. And for me, I thought he was doing an act. He was being comedic. And then Will Smith just kind of went overboard.
Oh my gosh, I agree
and
with you.
And her, did you see her resting bee face?
Well, yeah. She was just like the instigator of all of it. I mean, that whole incident, I said this before on the show, and I still feel that way. I used to really like Jada, but after that, I don't know, I don't care for her at all anymore. It's like, you manipulated that whole thing, and you took no responsibility.
Yeah.
So, you know, and Will did what he did, don't get me wrong, because he is just as bad. but it was like, man, you guys ruined that whole thing. Yeah. And then to that point, I remember because people were like, oh, the Oscars were on? And then it's like, it's that incident that made people even aware that the Oscars were being
mm-hmm. have been long forgotten.
Okay, I know.
So Chris Rock, nice. Yes, Pookie.
Pookie.
From New Jack City. Oh, love it.
It's a good one.
Yes. SNL, too.
I'm going to go with my number two as Cat Williams.
Cat okay. Williams.
Yeah. The Pimp Chronicles.
The Pimp Chronicles.
The Pimp Chronicles. Yes. The Pimp Chronicles, yes.
Yes, yes.
Yeah, he just, from start to finish on that one had me laughing.
Yeah, exactly. And I still like that meme because I put it up maybe about a year ago. It's like, pimp down. He's laying.
I love that guy.
Yeah, he's so crazy. I like it. So my number two is the guy that I first saw, of course, from In Living Color. And then he was very much in the stand-up world, Mr. Jim Carrey.
Yeah.
Of course, his movies blew up. He became Ace Ventura and so many other characters, you know, and he had the hugest career. And then, but his stand-up comedy was, it was very, very funny. And then, of course, everything he did on In Living Color was just like, oh my gosh, you watched that show. I hate to say it because the weigh-ins were so amazing, but you watched it for Jim Carrey. Okay.
That is an awesome one.
Yeah, let's get there. Okay, guys, with the little bit of time that we have left, let's run through the national date.
Oh, okay. I thought we were going to number one.
No, we'll get there after that. And again, this is Little River Band with Lonesome Loser in the background. Okay, so on Sunday, it was National Geologist Day. It was also National Coffee Cake Day. And I can't believe it would be on a Sunday, but it was National Beer Day.
Ooh.
Why would they do that on a Sunday? I don't know.
After church, you gotta have that. Cold one.
During church, I guess. I'll see it that way and whatever. So, it's time for me to stand according to my watch. Okay, so Little River Band with Lonesome Loser. Gotta say you love it. Okay, and then it was also National Beer Day. So on Monday was National Empanada Day. That's this Mexican kind of, it's almost like a runza. It's got meat and cheese and other stuff in it and that kind of thing.
Okay. Don't laugh at how I spell it.
Empanada. P-A-N. Yeah.
Oh.
See it?
Yeah.
So, yep. It was National Empanada Day and it was National Zoo Lovers Day on Monday.
Ooh.
So now playing in the background, of course, is Journey with Lovin', Touchin', and Squeezin'. Okay, one of their early hits. Also on Tuesday then was National Unicorn Day. It was National Chinese Almond Cookie Day.
Ooh.
Do they still sell those at Chinese Chef?
I think they do, but
that was the only place I knew that had them.
Yeah, I didn't. The last time I seen them, they didn't have the little almond in them.
Oh, they were just cookies? The cookie. Oh, ooh, they want the almond. So National Chinese Almond Cookie Day on Tuesday, and also National Winston Churchill Day.
Oh.
Celebrating the iconic British leader from the World War II era. So yesterday, Wednesday, was National Farm Animal Day. So go hug your chicken and cow and pig. It was also National Siblings Day. So slap the hell out of your siblings.
Yeah.
And it was also National Cinnamon Crescent Roll Day.
Jeez.
So basically like a crescent roll, but it's cinnamon. Okay, so then today is National Submarine Day, so shout out to all the naval people out there on their submarine. And it is also National Cheese Fondue Day. Do you like cheese fondue?
I've only had it like one time in my life.
I prefer queso.
I prefer queso.
It is also just generically today National Pet Day. So love your pet, yes. And it is also National 8-Track Day. Speaking of the 70s.
I know.
Did you have an 8-Track player, Sharon Teed? I know you did not miss
me. We did. My mom had to have all types of music.
Yeah.
And we did have an 8-Track player that was on a stereo console.
And weighed 4,000
pounds. And then it pushed
pounds.
It down into the... Yeah.
Yeah. Have you ever seen an 8-Track?
I have not.
Okay. Yeah. When we were at the... what do you call them? The bins, but they have a name. Anyway, there was 8-track tape. Then there were blank ones.
Wow.
Yeah, still wrapped in packaging. It's like, oh my gosh, who didn't use these in
how
the
70s? How do you record on those?
You did. Remember, basically, they were like a cassette, and you could only go in one direction, but whatever. So. Okay, so then that is today, and then tomorrow is National Only Child Day. Do you know any only children? I don't. Mm. I don't think I do anyway.
No.
Yeah. So then also National Colorado Day. So shout out to all the people in Colorado listening to us. Tomorrow is your day. It is also National Grilled Cheese Day.
Ooh, I love it. Cheese.
I want to take part in that.
I know. It is National...
With Kamad Cheese.
Oh, geez. Licorice Day tomorrow.
I love licorice.
And it is National Big Wind Day.
I love big wind.
So you're going to make a big wind after your grilled cheese? So then Saturday...
Since you requested.
Yeah, so Saturday, of course, is National Peach Cobbler Day. It is National Boricua Day. Those are the people in Puerto Rico. It is also National Scrabble Day. Mm-hmm. And it is National Make Lunch Count Day.
Okay.
So you're supposed to have lunch and do it in an effective way. Okay, guys, we got a few minutes left here. Of course, that is Journey's Lovin', Touchin', and Squeezin'. We're going to go out with our deep cut. It is also from Journey. And it is When the Lights Go Down in the City.
This is my song. Okay. I love this song.
Number one for our comedians, guys.
I'll go first.
Okay.
My number one is Dave Chappelle. I just love that guy. Yep. I wish that he's come back.
I know. I loved him on Saturday Night Live. I loved it. Everything he did there was just you're missing all of it so much. And the characters he brought back were just so crazy. Loved it.
Just earlier, me and my sister Maddie were talking about... We were talking about something, but somehow the word Samson came up in that part. He's like, Samson! Or whatever. I kept saying it, and it was just a little random moment today. But shout out to Dave Chappelle.
You guys both knew what you were talking
about.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, so indeed. Mine, okay. I've been watching the last, 3 days, clips and different stand-up. Of Pete Davidson, because my girls are gonna go see him.
Yep,
he's your number one.
Yeah.
Aye. Okay.
And you guys don't like him, but he's funny.
He is funny. I'll agree with you. Yeah.
I wouldn't put him at number one.
Well, he's my number one just because I've been watching him this last 3 days because I wanted to see what the big deal is about him because I don't watch Saturday Night Live, and they paid to get front row tickets, so then I just want to know, what he's all about, and then I was laying there really laughing watching him.
Yeah, he's great. He's crazy. So that's good. So my number one, of course, is posthumously one of the icons of the comedy world, the one, the only, Joan Rivers. Everything she ever did was just absolutely hilarious. Nothing was sacred, including her own life's journey. She made fun of everything and in the way that made you laugh, and I miss her dearly because she would be tearing into these political people in ways that others would be scared to. A trailblazer not only for female comedians but comedians in general.
But when I do that, you tell me to behave.
So Joan Rivers. Okay, the last few seconds we got here. Thank you guys for joining us on the Rez Ride. Any shout outs?
Shout out to my grandson, Hunter LaPointe.
Oh,
it's his
Hunts
birthday today.
Oh, happy
and
birthday.
And shout out to Delia, MC Delight, Dia, Dahlia, Dahlia. Happy birthday. And my friend, Joy St. Cyr Long. It's her birthday. Joy
really?
Long.
Okay.
Yes. So happy birthday, Joy. And just been friends for a long, 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 long time. But yeah, that's it.
I'm going to give a shout out to a happy belated shirt out. I'm just combining my words. Happy belated birthday to my sister, Cherise Bass. Her birthday was yesterday.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
And also just remember to tune in with Baby Bison Beats, MC Ash, and Lil Zane. They have a new episode Thursday evenings, 7 to 8 p.m.
Okay. Very good. Very good. So thank you guys for joining us here on the Rez Ride, KWTN 100.9 FM. Remember, we're here every Thursday from 4 to 6. Dwayne will hold on to that t-shirt for you, but we're going to be giving away more.
Wear it one time.
On all the other shows, yeah. Don't forget Baby Bison Beats and Midnight Love coming up later on. So thank you for joining us. Our deep cut, of course, Journey's When the Lights Go Out in the City. Turn it up.
The Big Voice. KWTN 100.9 FM. Allen, Nebraska. The official radio station of the Winnebago Tribe.